And we're coming to you live for the Built Ford Tough Studio. Boomer Esiason, Greg Giannotti. It's Boomer and Geo on the Fan, simulcast across the country on CBS Sports Network. And wherever you are in the free Odyssey app, good Thursday morning. Happy baseball fans this morning. The New York Yankees and New York Mets win in convincing fashion. Obviously, what's going on with the Yankees? We are in the midst of one of these special seasons. As I was driving home yesterday, I was listening to our guy, BT, and BT was talking about Giancarlo Stanton, and Giancarlo Stanton hits another home run last night, and he has looked great, and he goes, I'm going to take the L. I'm going to take the L on this one. Giancarlo Stanton, I thought he was done. I thought we'd never see this out of him again, and I'm taking the L. I don't think you could take the L on that on June 12th, June 13th. This Giancarlo Stanton, okay, he's looked great. He's hit some home runs, fine. We've got a long way to go with him staying healthy. And you know what happens to him. He could disappear for weeks and weeks and weeks. So, yeah, good start for him. But I ain't taking an L on Giancarlo Stanton being done. I got to see it when it's important. Good morning, Boomer. How are you?
Yeah, good morning, Jay. I'm doing well. It is when Juan Soto's in the lineup, they're totally like unstoppable.
Yeah.
And it's obvious to everybody. And then Gleyber Torres gets involved last night. This is the thing about the Yankee lineup. A couple guys don't hit home runs. There are a few other guys in this damn lineup that can hit home runs. They are a juggernaut. There's no question about it. I would have loved to have seen Soto against the Dodgers. It's unfortunately we didn't see that. But, I mean, like last night it was Gleyber Torres night. You know, he had a home run. And, you know, of course, Trevino had a home run. And, you know, this team is like, you know, must, like I always say, it's must see TV. You have to watch them. And
they're beating up, like the Royals are not like some
team.
Yeah, I mean, they came into the series 9 games over 500. And then the Yankees are just smacking them around.
They are smacking them around. And they got a game this afternoon, a getaway day. And it's kind of fun to know that you can watch a game, you know, on a Thursday afternoon. And quite frankly, it's one of those seasons, and you can feel it, you can see it. They've only lost 3 games in a row once, and that was back towards the beginning part of the season. I was looking at their schedule. They've lost back-to-back a couple of times. But, man, they are just rolling, and they're a lot to deal with if you're an opposing pitcher. So whether Brandon takes the L or whatever in June.
Taking the L.
I'll tell you, take an L from me. I can tell you that right now. I mean, yesterday he sent me a long text that he wanted a set of golf clubs because he hurt his back.
See, I didn't know anything about this now.
Right. I guess he's got a bad back or something. I'm not really sure. And he sent a text to me as we were on the air yesterday wanting to see if I had an extra left-handed set of golf clubs available for him.
He's lefty.
Well, I think he wanted to try playing lefty just to see if it would not hurt his back. Is that right, Al?
Okay. All right.
Right. So I basically put an entire set of golf clubs together for him because I have about 30 sets.
Okay.
I'm very lucky.
Yeah.
You know, I get a
fortunate.
Very fortunate. I've bought a lot of golf clubs in my life. I also have been gifted a few sets of golf clubs in my life, so I put them a beautiful set together. We got that beautiful Casamigos bag that Lee sent us.
That's right.
I had this thing set up, and I took a picture, and I said, hey, is this what you're looking for?
Mm-hmm.
Because and he goes, well, you know, I'm playing right now, and I'm playing righty. I said, is this what you're looking for? And then I said, I guess you want to get back into the five-borough bike tour again.
Ooh.
I didn't want to make him pay for it.
Oh, okay.
Didn't want to make him pay for it.
Yeah, of course. Yeah,
but you know, like he wanted the helmet. I'm surprised he hasn't come in and asked for this helmet.
Well, he knew what he got into last time when he asked for a helmet. He ended up on that bike up to Verrazano. He said he had a great time, but then he didn't do it this year. So I don't know how much of a great.
So I think the set of clubs that I had set aside for him was probably about a $5,000 set of clubs.
Wow. I mean, that's
and they were left-handed, and I had them all packed up and ready to go. And then all of a sudden, when I said, I guess you're into the five-borough bike tour again, he goes, I don't think I need them. Like, you know, or something
wow.
like that, I guess what he said.
So you basically wasted your time.
He
sends you this long text about, can you help me out? I'm going to try to play lefty because my back is a mess. You put this thing together. You're about to gift him a 5,000. Yeah, it's beautiful. All those clubs in. I mean, what do you got, 14 clubs in there and a putter and into that beautiful new Casamigos golf bag. And you say, hey, you know, it's almost like joking, like, you want to be in the bike tour again? And he goes, no, I don't need him.
He just said, hey, brother, odd question, but I figured I would ask you before getting bent over at the store.
Oh, wow.
He didn't want to get bent over at the store. I'm only reading this because I think it's funny. I'm not trying to out him or anything. It's funny.
Well, yeah.
He goes, at the store, regarding golf, I'm abandoning playing lefty. I abandoned playing lefty. Long story. Back yips, etc. Is there any chance you happen to have a set or just irons laying around that I can buy off of you?
Oh, it's nice to buy. You didn't ask for it for free.
Quality really doesn't matter. Just want to see if I can do it before I truly commit to usual tailor-mades, right-handed ones.
Okay.
I mean, I'm left-handed, so I don't know what he's thinking, right?
Mm-hmm.
So these are all tailor-mades in this bag.
Okay.
Including the driver, including, there's a Maverick Rescue Club in there.
Okay.
The driver and the 3-wood are tailor-mades.
Okay.
And the putter is a spider.
Very nice.
So, and then I said, you ready for another bike tour with that picture?
Yeah.
And he goes, playing righty now, with a smiling and laughing emoji. So I guess you don't need him. He goes, I don't, but thank you, brother.
Ooh, so
there you go.
See, we like Brandon a lot.
Well,
Brandon obviously doesn't know that you don't waste your time in a situation like that, because then you run the risk of getting frozen out for a little bit, because you're a very busy guy. You got a lot of stuff going on. You want to help out a friend.
Of course.
And then
one that wants to get back into golf, and I'm all for that.
Right. You take time out of your day to put this together. You say, hey, this is what you're looking for. You're probably like, hey, look, I got this thing done for you. It's $5,000 worth of clubs. Here you go. Ready to go. He goes, no, I don't think I need it anymore.
I had Richie put in like a couple dozen balls, too.
Oh, wow. Man, oh, man. He says...
There you go.
And now he doesn't want it.
He's going to jam it up his A gap.
So I was wondering why, because I brought up the BT take about taking an L, and then I felt a little bit of an ice cold response from you, and I was trying to figure out why. Now I know why, because I brought up a guy who pissed you off yesterday.
Well, he didn't really piss me off, but I just put me out a little bit.
Yeah. Well,
a little bit, just a little bit. A
little tiny bit.
A little bit, yeah.
All right, so he's now.
I was all, ready to rock and roll. I had him brought in and was ready to bring him in today, and he said he didn't need him.
Man, so he's ambidextrous as BT?
I guess he is. I mean, I have no idea what's going on with him. I guess he basically stopped playing golf because of his back, I think.
Yeah, yeah. Oh,
then now because he's, I was listening a little bit yesterday.
Yeah.
That they were talking about the U.S. Open that starts today. It's down at Pinehurst, #2. And his golf course is diabolical, by the way, looking at all the Instagram posts coming out of the PGA Tour players and watching them watch the ball roll off these greens going in different directions and everything else. It's going to be carnage.
Yes.
Is what it's going to be down there in North Carolina as they get started this morning.
Yeah. So, all right. So there's a little bit of Tiger Woods here on CBS Sports Network. So I'm sure that people will be paying attention to him for a little bit. They always do on Thursday and Friday, and then that's the end of it, because he usually either misses the cut or he's nowhere in contention. So I appreciate the coverage because people still want to see him, but he's not going to factor into anything interesting. So, yeah. All right. So BT taking the L. BT's back leads me back into, do we still have the list of injuries of Giancarlo Stanton that we took at the beginning of the season that was going to put him on the IL at first? Because I don't think that we do. I was looking through my phone all this morning, and I couldn't find it. I don't know if Al wrote it down.
I mean, that would be something that the producer would, I think, write down
somewhere. Don't think we did it this year.
I thought we did.
No.
Oh, good. That's even better then. Even better. Because I don't want to jinx the guy. I'm just saying right
Sounds
now.
Sounds like you are jinxing him.
But this is the time to do it. This is because everybody's like, man, he's healthy. He's got a new body.
He's productive.
He's hitting home runs again.
Smashing home runs.
He's killing it.
Oh, yes.
So now is the time, I think, that everybody thinking positive about him. This is the time that you throw out there, do you think he's going to get hurt again?
I'm not a Yankee fan. I don't want to go down this road with Yankee fans, because then they start hating me because we buy into all of this. I want the guy to have a great year.
You're saying he's going to stay healthy the rest of the year?
No.
Okay.
He's not going to. Right.
That's
that.
All I'm saying.
But I don't want to jinx the guy.
There's no jinxing him. It's not possible.
Could you make an argument, I guess, since Brandon's taking an L on this, can you make the argument that he is playing his best baseball as a Yankee right now in terms of offensive output?
In this stretch, yes. I mean, he did put together a really good season in his, was it first or second season? He carried them offensively for a while. He was good in the postseason. But, yeah, I mean, this stretch right now in this lineup, he looks as lethal as he has since he's been a Yankee, yes.
You know, maybe the new body, the whole, you know, losing some weight, working on your stretching, that kind of thing has really helped him. So here's what I love about this is that this is a very highly paid athlete.
Yeah.
Here's an athlete who probably felt embarrassed or has felt embarrassed over the last couple of years and all the injuries that has hit him. And he really, really tried to do something about it. And I think we are seeing the fruits of his offseason labor.
Yeah, and I also think that, you know, we so easily forget when things are going well that things can still go wrong.
Yeah, but things don't go well very often around here.
Yeah,
that's,
I know.
That's the thing. And like the Rangers season, it was great. It was awesome until they ran into an awesome team and unfortunately couldn't beat them in overtime and they end up losing. But I still celebrated a great season for games that I look forward to. Watching, and it's the same thing with the Yankees, right? The Yankees are in the middle of a very, very special season.
They are.
You can feel it.
But it's funny to me that after all these years of Giancarlo Stanton pulling this, he's on the IL, he disappears for a while, we don't know where he is, that 2 months of him being healthy and playing well, that everybody, that we got Brandon taking the L, you got, oh, look, Giancarlo Stanton's back, I was wrong about him. What? That's all it takes is 2 months? 2 months to wipe away all of that?
Well, they were killing Brian Cashman in the offseason.
Two months?
They kill him all the time.
You know? A healthy 2 months, and now Giancarlo Stanton's back, and he's going to be hitting in the postseason. He's going to play 150 games. Come on.
Well, maybe he will.
Maybe he will. Chances are he won't.
New body, G.
New body?
Remember, you got a new body.
New body?
You worked on your
body. We heard the same thing last year the new body.
You worked on your body.
I didn't really lift or anything.
But I know that, but you worked on your body.
Yeah, okay.
You did, and you did a good job.
And I'm still pulling muscles.
And you're healthy.
No, still pulling muscles.
Where are you pulling muscles?
You know, all the time.
When?
You know, it's just how you feel it and they get up, you get a cramp in your leg, you know.
That's not pulling a muscle. I mean, he probably gets up and has cramps too. I know Al has cramps.
Yes, a lot of cramps.
A lot of cramps for Al.
A lot.
But I think that, you know, I don't want to wish ill on anybody, especially an athlete that did something in the offseason that is, if I were a fan of the Yankees, and I just as an ex-professional athlete that I am,
yeah,
I appreciate the attention to detail that he put into his own body to keep him healthy. I really do. And I'm not bullcrapping anybody.
No bullcrapping.
I'm serious about that because a lot of times we see guys that say that they've done all this work in the offseason when in fact they did nothing.
Sure.
This guy obviously did something and wanted to come back and had some pride in his performance and in his reputation. And right now he's living a good life, but he's in the midst of this lineup that is ridiculous.
That is true. And I appreciate all that too. I think we heard some of the same stuff last year about him coming into the season and changing his body. And it's not wishing ill on a guy. It's just, to me, it's more the reaction of the Yankee fan that is caught up in this season and just thinks that Giancarlo Stanton, because the year's going the way that it's going, that Giancarlo Stanton, after a healthy 2 months, is just going to cruise his way into the playoffs without having an injury, having this spectacular season. And you can't count on that.
Would you say that, I don't know, percentage-wise, you got your ear to the ground. You could sniff this out for me. And if you wouldn't mind sniffing it out for me, the percentage of Ranger fans that you believe are also Yankee fans?
There's a lot of them, I would say.
What, it's like 75%?
Yeah.
Traditional teams, original six teams, the Yankees.
Let's put it this way. It's definitely over 60%.
Okay. So those fans that are Ranger fans like me, you know, had such disappointment towards the end there losing to Florida. But then the Ranger fan who is the Yankee fan wakes up and they are, as well as the Rangers are or were, in the midst of a season where you don't want to miss a game. You don't know what's going to happen. You don't know who's going to hit a 450-foot home run. Is there a pitcher that's going to throw a no-hitter? Is there going to be another spectacular play, you know, by Anthony Volpe, who, by the way, has been terrific, the table setter? I mean, so I know exactly how the Yankee fan feels because that's how I felt about the Rangers season.
Well, not Sean Morash of Evan and Tiki, because he said after the Rangers disappointment, he now has no excitement for the Yankees because they're going to let him down just like the Rangers
all
did.
Right, listen, I mean, not everybody. You know what? I love Sean because he takes the slings and arrows that come along with his opinions, and he's a big friend. He's a friend of our show.
Yeah, we love him. Yeah,
there's a lot of dopey crap for us, and we love that.
We love that.
We love how he buys.
He's an all-in guy.
He's an all-in guy, and I love that. But I am not going to let his take on whatever fandom he has to be a part of ruin what I think is a very special season that is happening.
Yeah, and no one's going to ruin it. No one's going to ruin it, but the guys that are on the field if they end up getting hurt. That's really the only thing. If we've learned one thing in this town, is that health, more than anything, is the killer. And we have seen it time and time again. So I just hope that this is different, but it's funny to me how all these sins of Giancarlo Stanton's soft tissue injuries have been washed away by two healthy months.
All right, let's not worry about the soft tissue injuries right now. I mean, okay. Watching the Celtics and the Mavericks last night, like the Celtics had a magic season going on all year long. And now, even without Porzingis, they're basically unstoppable.
Porzingis.
Yep. Even without him, they are unstoppable. And they are in the midst of a sweep. I don't know if they'll get the sweep, but I'll tell you what. It looks like Luka and everybody else is kind of like giving up on this thing.
Luka was complaining. He fouled out, complaining about the officials. I mean, the NBA.
That means they're giving up.
The NBA could not be in a worst situation with an interesting matchup on paper prior to the finals starting. It's dead. Nobody cares. They're manufacturing arguments about Jason Tatum and Jalen Brown. It's a non-story. The NBA finals nationally is a non-story right now.
I know it is. You have to check in. You got to watch it. You got to see it.
I don't. I have no interest in that whatsoever, especially now 3-0. I mean, there isn't a single Knicks fan that really gives a crap about this series after the run that they were on. Nobody cares. It's just frustrating to think that if a healthy Knicks team could have maybe taken on the Celtics team and at least given them hell for a few games at the very least, as opposed to laying down like a bunch of dogs like the Pacers and the Mavericks did.
Well, kind of like the Rangers did with the Florida Panthers.
They gave them a series. Gave them a series. Absolutely.
Right. I mean, I don't know. Listen, between the soft tissue and the Mavericks losing and on the verge of getting swept, it's awesome. It's actually awesome.